Sunday school lessons for years, many years, and I saved them. And when in my earlier days, I used to teach school, and the Lord kind of sort of prepared me for doing this because I taught English, and so I know what correct English is, and so He just kind of prepared me for this so that people could understand me. And the reason I have quite a bit of work on anger is that you may not want this information, but I'm going to tell you. My husband was an alcoholic. He's dead now. And he used to defend himself with a verbal attack. So I learned how to deal with things like that. And I like to share that because it's so frustrating for someone to attack you with words and with anger. And you better learn how to handle it because you have to handle it. And so I have some things I wrote down some things that I thought would help others to handle anger when it comes at you. Now, actually, I never had an anger problem, really, any more than the ordinary person would. But most people who are on drugs or alcohol have an anger problem. And many perfectly normal people have an anger problem. And they need all the help they can get to know how to handle it. My husband, I want you to know this, my former husband received Christ. Amen. And the methods that the Lord used on him helped him to deal with it, to deal with his anger. And it was a victory in the end because he received Christ, and I'll tell you about it if you want to know about it.
It's very, very common.
Yes, yeah. It is.
And it's who's the father of lies? This devil. So when he wears you and you're doing something wrong, he's gonna use to lie, to deceive, to be angry, to speak more words at you, so that he can stop you, he can demoralize you.
Yeah.
That's the plan.
I never had been around people who had substance abuse. And I never was around alcohol when I was growing up. And I didn't know my husband was an alcoholic when I married him. Now, it's not my David I'm talking about.
No,
I understand
David
that. This man that I had the problem with, he's deceased.
Mm-hmm.
But that's the occasion I had to seek out information because I didn't know anything about alcoholism. I didn't know anything about this type of thing. But the Lord taught me.
Yes.
It's straight from Him.
Yeah. You know, He uses our experiences. Like, you didn't come from a home which had this, but now you married somebody with this one. How do you handle it?
Right.
Because we're going to meet different people at work, in our marriages. So it's very important we learn how to handle them.
Mm-hmm.
Even though we've never dealt with these people, but then we're going to marry them, we're going to be at workplace. On the roads, we see rage on the road.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So,
absolutely.
It's very
There's
important.
A lot of anger in our world.
Very. And many kids whose father left them, they are angry.
Yes. That's true.
You know, everybody's angry at something, at someone.
Absolutely.
My mom did teach me this, I'm angry. I'm this. Instead of accepting their problem, like, I'm an alcoholic, but they have anger toward, they didn't teach me.
Mm-hmm. James 1:19-20 is where I want to start in the Word.
But you didn't introduce yourself.
Oh. I'm Doris Sumner, and I'm 91. And the word says that you can live to be 120. So I thought, well, I'm a good candidate for that. Amen. Why not just shoot for that?
Amen.
So I tell people about it, and it opens doors for people who have a problem with anger. It opens doors for me, and that's why that I tell them.
Amen.
I would not tell them otherwise. I just
you experienced it.
So I use that to open doors because they know that I have done and been through that myself.
Amen.
James 1:19-20. This is what it says. Everyone must be quick to hear, slow to speak, and slow to anger. For the anger of man does not achieve the righteousness of God. Let me say that again. Everyone must be quick to hear, slow to speak, and slow to anger. For the anger of man does not achieve the righteousness of God. This is a very wise statement, and I have reminded myself of it hundreds of times.
Yeah.
You know, you're perfectly justified in getting angry when a person attacks you. I mean, that's just something that God put in us. It's when we're attacked, when an animal attacks another one, that animal gets angry. Mm-hmm. And that's exactly what we do. It's a defense mechanism that we get angry at them because they're angry with us. But it doesn't accomplish the works of God. So you, not that you're not justified, you are. And anger itself is not bad. It's put in us for a reason. But it doesn't accomplish the works of God. So you may as well figure out some other way to handle it than to get angry, because all that will happen is a fight. If someone is angry and just lashes out at you, it's normal to respond, well, you know, you shouldn't have done that, and to counterattack. Mm-hmm. But it says here in James 1:19-20, he didn't say, well, you shouldn't have gotten angry. He said it won't accomplish the works of God. So we need to remember that.
That's
not the way, if you want a solution, that's not the way to do it. And it has a negative effect. If you get angry in response to anger, it has a negative response. It's not good. Anger in itself is not sin. In Psalms 18, there is an account where God got angry at someone who was attacking his children. I believe it was David that they were attacking. And God responded with anger. Mm-hmm. But now he's God. That's God. He's righteous. He has no unrighteousness in him.
Amen.
And when he responds to anger, it's not the same thing. when David cried out to God, God came to his rescue. And he came with thunder and lightning and all the emotions. He came at the... But he's angry at Satan.
Yes.
He's angry at the source of the problem. Mm-hmm. He's angry with Satan.
At the root.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But we're not to respond by being angry with the person that does that. We're not God, and we're not perfect, and we're not pure.
That's powerful.
Like God is.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to find a solution that God approves of. God hates sin. He really hates it, and he hates the author of sin. who is Satan.
Satan.
And he hates what it can do to people when a person attacks them. And I'm glad he takes care of the enemy.
Amen.
Satan, it's okay, that, but he is God and he is pure. But we need not abuse ourselves and criticize ourselves if we feel the emotion of anger, because it's a good emotion.
It's a good emotion. That's right.
It just doesn't accomplish the works of God.
Wow. Mm.
I'm not going to go into that about David. But he delivered David from his enemies. That's what he did. And he will deliver us from our enemies. And we don't have to double up our fists and go at them with anger. That's not the
solution. It's his work. It's his job. Right?
It is. The Bible says, God, vengeance is
mine,
says the Lord. And he knows how to handle it. And we need to learn how to handle it. We need skills as to how to handle this. I used to have the habit. It was my habit. I if anybody got angry with me, I got angry with them. There's something about me that just
payback.
You know, if somebody got really angry with me, I got angry. And I thought, why am I doing that? I don't want to be angry. I mean, why am I angry? Why do I let them make me angry? You know, nobody can make you do anything.
Nope.
You do it because you do it. Now, don't go and blame it on somebody. I got angry with you because you attacked me, or because you got angry with me. It's a response to anger. And that's not the right solution, the word just said. I've heard people call it, well, they always push my button. They don't have to.
Yeah.
What you think and what you decide to do about it, you have to have a plan. That pleases God and that God will support you in. Maybe you're a button pusher.
Maybe, yeah.
A lot of people are. And they feel perfectly justified.
Sometimes we don't even know it.
That's true. This will make us knowledgeable about it.
Mm-hmm.
If we're aware of it, that we have a problem like that, we can look at it squarely and have a plan that we won't respond with anger and let a fight come about. So, examine yourselves. What are some things that you respond to with anger every time? You know, things that you don't like that anger is the thing that I responded to before I understood that we have to handle anger and that God is the one who takes revenge. We don't do that.
Amen.
We're not called to that. Galatians 5:13 says, "For you were called to freedom, brethren. Only do not turn your freedom into an opportunity to the flesh, but through love serve one another. For the whole law is fulfilled in one statement. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. But if you bite and devour one another, take care that you're not consumed by one another. But I say, walk in the Spirit, and you will not carry out the desire of the flesh."
Amen.
Your flesh wants to respond with anger when someone attacks you.
Yes.
But you've got to find another way to do it, because we know from the Word that that will not accomplish the works of God. Of the flesh are evident. Evidently, they're things of the flesh. Like, let's see. immorality, impurity, sensuality, idolatry, sorcery, enmities, strife, jealousy, and outburst of anger is one of those. Outbursts of anger. That's of the flesh. Disputes and dissensions. Uncontrolled anger is the deed of the flesh. Uncontrolled anger. It's okay to feel anger when someone attacks you. But you better get over it.
Wow.
Because that won't accomplish the works of God. And it's a deed of the flesh. Anger can be used by the flesh. And it's not okay to let it be uncontrolled. In fact, anger is dangerous when it's uncontrolled.
Oh, yes.
About 99% of our anger is from our flesh, because we being stepped on. We feel like someone is stepping on us.
Wow.
A big percent.
Yes.
Is fleshly. Now sometimes, like I said, God got angry, but he didn't use it. He didn't have flesh like we have. And he didn't counterattack. That's not the right way. So dying to the flesh is one of the things that we have to do.
Mm-hmm.
Dying to the flesh. We can't indulge. Okay, someone attacks you. We can't indulge in that, because we know from the word that it will not
accomplish
the works of God.
I like that.
Do it. I love that.
I want to take that.
Keep it, memorize it, because I've used it 10,000 times.
It is so good. If it's, what are you doing? It's not accomplishing the work of God.
You think, well, I've heard people say, well, I have a right to be angry. They did so and so. Yeah, you have a right to be angry, but it won't accomplish the works of God.
Wow, that's good.
Sometimes a person flies off and gets angry at you because they're frustrated. Mm-hmm. You know, they just can't accomplish what they want, and they don't deserve it, you know. And there are many reasons why people get angry. You need to be wise, and you need to understand why they're getting angry.
And most of all, we have to remember it will not accomplish the work. So
absolutely.
I love it. That's a powerful statement. I think if we have it in our mind, then we are going to think of
knowledge. Next time. Knowledge is important to have.
Mm-hmm.
Proverbs 29:11 says, a fool always loses his temper. I don't want to be a fool. I don't want it. A fool always loses his temper, but a wise man holds it back. Ask for wisdom. What is it about wisdom? Wisdom is free. What God said in James 1:5-8, but if any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives to all generously and without reproach. That means he's not going to talk about you for needing wisdom. You know, he's not going to fuss at you for needing wisdom.
Wow.
He gives to all generously and without reproach, and it will be given to him. You just ask for it. But he must ask, here's the key to part of it. He must ask in faith without anything, without any doubting. For one who doubts is like the surf of the sea, driven and tossed by the word. For that man ought not to expect that he will receive anything from the Lord. Being a double-minded man, unstable in all of his ways. So that's one of the things you have to work on. If you have an angry person around you.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes a person gets angry or says something to you in anger, and what happens? You also get angry. I had to learn not to respond with anger.
Wow, that's powerful. We have to learn not to respond.
Because anger does not accomplish the works of God.
Wow. Powerful teaching.
Yeah. Now, the man who was my husband at the time was later delivered and restored.
Amen.
But if I hadn't been willing to get control of my anger and
not respond
in anger, mm-hmm. he probably never would have come to the Lord. Well, does it hurt you not to respond to anger? It doesn't. It doesn't hurt you if he's not hitting you. I don't believe you should allow a person to hit you and physically abuse you. Mm-hmm. I just don't think you're
that's
not being
right.
Godly when you let somebody just beat up on you physically.
No.
That is not, we don't go that far with it.
No.
You can always remove your presence from them, usually, I'd say, mostly.
Mm-hmm.
You can get out of their presence if they're trying to hit you. You don't have to take that.
No.
But I remember my husband one time said to me, when he said, a good defense is a good offense. He told me that.
What does that mean?
A good defense. If you want to defend yourself, you go after that person. And that's what he did. That's what he used to do. He would come home and he would despise himself because he had yielded to anger and abused his family verbally. So he didn't like himself. So he would attack me. And many times that's the reason a person gets angry. He really is angry with himself.
Wow, yeah, that's very true.
So that's what he meant when he said, a good defense is a good offense. If he could make me angry, he'd say, oh yeah, you got angry too. You know,
wow.
So we got angry.
Yeah.
He got angry and I got angry. Well, that takes a lot of that blame off him, doesn't it?
Yeah.
You can't do it. And, you know, Jesus endured the cross because of the reward that was set before him, which was his mankind that he loved so much. He endured the cross. And it doesn't hurt us to endure, not beatings, I didn't say that, but we can endure words.
Mm-hmm. And then you also remember who's defending you.
You're right.
When you remember
that. We have the Lord.
The Lord.
This is the way I learned to reason with myself,
mm-hmm.
which kept me from responding to all the anger directed at me. This is what I would say in my mind. In my mind, I didn't tell him that. I would say, I'm sorry you are frustrated and angry. Actually, I don't choose to take on the mood that you have.
Wow.
I don't, you're attacking me. I don't choose to be angry. Now, you can respond in anger if you want to, but it won't accomplish anything. But you cannot respond to the words that are being said over you. You cannot respond. Did you know that you cannot respond?
To what?
An attack, anger attack.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about an anger attack.
Because it will not accomplish.
Because it won't accomplish anything. So let's wise up. We know it's not going to accomplish anything.
Nothing.
The word says that.
And then you make the other person justify themselves.
You make them. Absolutely.
Yeah.
That's my point.
Mm-hmm. I get it.
So, see, she's a smart lady.
I get it. It makes a lot of sense.
Yes, it does. Yes. This is what you say to yourself. I'm sorry you're frustrated and angry. Actually, I don't choose to feel frustrated and angry today. I feel good. Why should I let you make me angry just because you're angry?
Wow.
I'm not gonna get angry. I don't choose to. It's a choice.
It's a choice.
Your response is a choice.
Yes.
You can decide not to go along with that path, which is the same. I've seen people in families do it over and over and over. In fact, I did it over and over for a long while, because I would prepare meals for him, and he would work all day and then stay at work, and his friends would drop by and he would start drinking, and there my supper would not be eaten that I worked hard for. So I thought, it's like beating your head against the wall, you know. You can beat your head up all day, and you know it's not gonna help. You know that's not the answer. Mm-hmm. I don't choose to be angry, and we have a choice. A person can't make you angry. I don't choose to be angry with you. You have your own feelings and I have mine. Mm-hmm. And I refuse to allow you to force me to feel the same way that you do. Mm-hmm. I can control my feelings, and with God's help you can. Mm-hmm. And you know, when you feel abused, it does something to you. You've heard stories about this poor little lady whose husband abuses her, and pretty soon she gets beaten down, she gets discouraged.
Yes. Uh-huh.
And she gets to thinking, many of them will think, well, something must be
wrong
with me.
Yeah.
I'm not okay, you know, something's wrong with me. And see, that's not the case.
So she believes all the lies
that's a good
enemy.
Point.
Using, of course, the husband or whichever is abusing you, you believe the enemy's words.
Absolutely, that's wise. That's a very wise,
very powerful.
And whenever I learned this, I'm sure my husband wondered why he was not able to manipulate me into getting as angry as he was. If he could ever make me get as angry as he was, then, oh well, we're buddies, you know.
Yes.
We're both angry, you know, and he wouldn't have to take any responsibility.
Wow.
For it.
That's powerful. I know, I'm thinking like that if you responded to what he was saying to you, you know, it will never stop.
You
what? It will never stop.
Right. It doesn't stop.
But when you chose to not to, something had to happen.
Something happened to him. Now, I won't say it happened immediately.
Mm-hmm.
It seemed like an eternity to me. But
when you're dealing with it, yes.
When you're dealing with it in your
day
home.
And night.
Mm-hmm. What spirit was he cooperating with? It wasn't
Satan.
God.
A Satan?
Yeah. The author of anger.
Father of lies.
Mm-hmm. Lies. He's the father of lies. Mm-hmm. The Bible says he can't tell the truth. There's always lies in what Satan will tell you. Somewhere there's some lies in it.
Wow.
And what spirit was strengthening me?
God.
He knew that was a good thing that I was doing. And he strengthened me in it. And he's on your side. He will help you because you're trying to do the works of God.
Amen.
Instead of the works of Satan. The devil's the one that plans this maneuver. And when we keep the peace of God, the devil suffers a huge defeat. When you can keep your peace, the devil he loses.
Amen.
And he knows it. And God and we win the victory. The devil cannot steal our peace unless we let him. Because this is what the word says. In 1 John 4:4, you are of God, my little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Learn that verse. Excuse me. It's 1 John 4:4. Learn it. Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world.
Amen.
And it's you and God. And who do you suppose wins that battle?
God.
He does. And you.
And me. Because he's my defender.
Yes, he is. So much is at stake in situations like the one that I described. So much damage can be done when one allows himself to be hurt. And dealing with it like I described left me completely unhurt and undamaged. I grew up with a healthy attitude.
Yeah.
God was my defender.
Amen.
I grew up and I didn't flaunt it before him. You know what I mean by flaunting it before?
Yes.
I didn't do that. Because except with God's help, I would have joined him in his anger.
Yes.
And it's damaging to embrace anger.
Wow.
It hurts you worse than it hurts the person who gets angry.
And everybody around you.
Everybody. Sometimes people don't realize that no one can make them angry. We have to allow it. When we get angry, we choose. We allow ourselves to get angry. So do not blame anyone but yourself when you get angry. I hated to lose that that defense if I allowed myself to get angry. But you don't have that defense.
Wow.
He didn't make you get angry. She didn't make you get angry.
You chose
to get angry. The one who can make you angry is showing greater strength than you have. And here's the shock of a lifetime. Everybody is not going to like you.
That's right.
That's all right. They choose. And you choose. There could be many reasons. You could remind them like of somebody that hurt them. There could be many reasons why they, or maybe you remind them of themselves, you know. But it's okay. Or a person not to like you, but he's not supposed to abuse you. And God is your defender, and he does.
Amen.
That doesn't mean that something's wrong with you when someone doesn't like you. Of course there's something wrong with everybody.
Yes.
We're not perfect.
No.
Except that there are some things that are peculiar just to you that others will just have to accept, just like you have to accept things about them. There are many people you love that you don't like something about them.
Yes.
And there are many people who love you who don't like certain things about you.
Yes.
But we can accept that because it will bring good and not evil to us.
Amen.
You and God together will have to make the decisions. Please don't set out to change everyone to your liking. You'll be disappointed.
That's good.
God created all of us different. Mm-hmm. And he loves the differences in us.
Amen.
He's so proud of his creation.
Yes.
Because he made them. It's like when you make something yourself with your hands. You're proud of it, aren't you?
Yes.
God is proud of mankind. He is so pleased with mankind.
Amen.
And he created all of us different.
Yes.
We need to know that.
Yeah.
And the Word of God addresses this in Romans 14. I'm not going to read it today, but go home and read Romans 14 because it talks about that. Staying in the Word is the best thing a person can do.
Mm-hmm.
We praise God and we are so thankful that he gives us a way out of every situation.
Amen.
We get, even if we're the cause of the situation, he wants us out of it.
Amen.
And he is able because he has lots of experience.
Yes.
And I thank him and I praise his name for recognizing this problem and helping us with it.
Hallelujah.
Praise your name, Lord.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you.
Praise your name.
For making the way where there's no way.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Absolutely.
Wonderful teaching. I have one question.
Okay.
Like, this is kind of a child, the parents, maybe like the dad, I'm giving an example, like the dad abused the, didn't be a father, he wasn't there, mm-hmm. and he's always lying, I'm gonna do this for you, and then they don't do it for you. And you find so many young people very angry. What can he do to be able to forgive the father? Because the more you hate your father, the devil doesn't care whether your father didn't take care of you.
Yeah.
He gets an entrance and then he uses you.
Yeah. You have to forgive. If you want to come out unhurt, you have to forgive.
In every situation, whatever they did to you. Wow.
Ask God to help you out of that situation.